Impella, Chapter 4, The Smart Assist System. Smart Assist is a monitoring system integrated into the next generation catheters and Impella console. It enables greater support, allows for easier and more precise repositioning of the catheter, improved detection of suction events, and enhanced weaning guidance. The main improvement in the device has been the implementation of an optical pressure sensor. The Smart Assist system is mainly based on this laser sensor. The advantages of this technology include the absence of a pressurized tubing line, more accurate and real-time pressure measurement, more precise position control, more precise suction event detection, and better guidance in weaning. The Impella device can determine pressure in real time using optical fiber and laser. This is called an optical pressure sensor. The system emits a pulse of laser towards a reflective diaphragm and measures the time it takes light to return. Knowing speed of light, device calculates the distance with great precision, in the range of micrometers. In a previous video, we have covered this topic in more detail. With Smart Assist system, there is a more precise position control. It is worth noting that the optical sensor is located in a more distal position of the device, practically at the outlet, while the previous sensor using pressurized tubing was located 2 or 3 centimeters more proximal. For example, this slide shows a slightly advanced position of the Impella catheter. The old pressure sensor would not detect a change in the pressure curve, thus presenting a typical arterial morphology. In contrast, with the optical sensor, a change in the curve would be identified, adopting a typical ventricular morphology. Left ventricle pressure estimation. The Impella catheter can estimate the left ventricular pressure and display a real-time curve, as well as estimate the left ventricular and diastolic pressure. As explained in our previous video, the current required to maintain the rotation speed depends mainly on the pressure difference between the two cavities. Knowing this, the company has designed an algorithm that relates the instantaneous pressure in the aorta with the current used by the motor to estimate the pressure of the left ventricle. But this estimation is only reliable at high rotation speeds, equivalent to P levels of 4 or higher. But in the hemodynamic management of a patient, the most important parameter of a left ventricular pressure curve is the end-diastolic pressure. The system detects the sudden increase in pressure that marks the beginning of systole and takes the pressure just before this change. The pressure captured corresponds quite accurately to the left ventricular end-diastolic pressure. Left ventricle end-diastolic pressure displayed is a mean value derived from the identified end-diastolic points on the left ventricle placement signal over the past 10 seconds. In this way, the console shows the value of the left ventricular end-diastolic pressure and its evolution in the preceding hours on one of the display screens. We must remember that these parameters are not direct measurements, but rather estimations derived from mathematical algorithms. This is why the values have a margin of error, as shown in this table. It is noteworthy the high percentage of error in the parameter of left ventricular end diastolic pressure, as an error of 5.3 millimeters of mercury is reported for values between 10 and 25 millimeters of mercury. For a better understanding of this topic, we recommend watching the corresponding video on our channel. Suction events detection. Due to the use of the digital pressure sensor and continuous monitoring of the left ventricle pressure, the device can detect suction events earlier. In this animation, we present a continuous suction event throughout diastole. Weaning management. Another piece of information that the Smart Assist system provides is the continuous estimation of cardiac output and cardiac power output. The console displays this data in real time. These are the formulas that the system uses to estimate cardiac output and cardiac power output. In this way, the console presents the evolution over the previous 12 hours of mean arterial pressure, left ventricular end diastolic pressure, total cardiac output, Impella flow, and native cardiac output. For example, In this slide, a favorable weaning process is shown, with a gradual decrease in P level, maintaining mean arterial pressure, and global cardiac output sustained by an increase in native output while reducing Impella catheter flow. You can obtain a more detailed information about this topic in one of our previous videos. If you've enjoyed our video, please press the like button and subscribe to support us so we can continue creating quality content like this.